6th standard students, let us start from page number 216, area of rectangle. With the help of a squared paper, can we tell what will be the area of rectangle whose length is 5 cm and breadth is 3 cm? Draw the rectangle on graph paper having 1 by 1 cm, 1 cm squares. The rectangle covers 15 squares completely. See the figure. Length is 5. So on the graph paper, and breadth is 3. Opposite sides of rectangles always equal. So now inside, how much region is covered by this rectangle? So count the squares. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. The area of rectangle 15 square centimeter, which can be written as 5 into 3 square centimeter, that is length into breadth. But when we calculate always by this method, it is time consuming method, or always we need graph paper, it will take time. And if we will calculate by this method length into breadth, so quickly we can calculate the area of rectangle. The measures of the sides of sum of rectangles are given. Find their areas by placing them on a graph paper and counting the number of squares. What do we infer from this? We find area of rectangle is equal to length into breadth. Every time when you will draw here, suppose that it is a 3 and you are taking 4 vertically, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. So you will get answer 12 square centimeter. Here 7, 5 is a 35, 5, 3 is a 15. You can do this activity yourself. So always the rectangle, area of rectangle will be length into breadth. Without using the graph paper, can we find the area of rectangle whose length is 6 cm and breadth is 4 cm? Yes, because we know this thing. If we multiply length by breadth, we will get area of rectangle. So length is 6, breadth is 4. 6, 4 is 24. Yes, it is possible. What do we infer from this? We find the formula. We got the formula of area of rectangle, that is length into breadth, 6, 4 is 24, centimeter into centimeter, square centimeter. Clear? Now area of a square. See here. Let us now consider a square of side 4 centimeter. What will be its area? So 4, length also 4, breadth also 4, because we know that in the square all sides are equal. Now reason. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 square centimeter. That means if we multiply side by side, we are getting the area of a square. So if we place it on a centimeter graph paper, then what do we observe? It covers a 16 square, that is the area of a square. 16 square centimeter equal to 4 into 4 square centimeter. Calculate areas of few squares by assuring length of one side of squares by yourself. Find the area, find their areas using graph papers. What do we infer from this? So we got the formula of area of a square, side into side. Clear? So we find that in each case area of a square equal to side into side. You may use this as a formula in doing problems. Illustrations you will solve. Okay, I will solve exercise for you. So what you will do before starting the 10.3, area of rectangle is equal to length into breadth. Area of a square is equal to side into side. Let us start exercise 10.3. Find the areas of rectangles whose sides are. You will solve this one. This is also you will solve. This also you will solve. I am solving for you this one. Okay. See, in this question, the length of rectangle is given 2 meter, breadth is equal to 70 centimeter. Here, units are different. So what we will do? We will change this centimeter into meter. So 70 upon 100. We will divide this quantity by 100. So 0.7 meter, or you can write 0.70 meter. Before two digits also, we can put decimal. Then area of rectangle is equal to length into breadth. Formula we know. So 2 into 0.7, that means 2 sevens are 14. Before one digit we will put decimal. So 1.4 square meter. Always एरिया इज देयर देन स्क्वायर सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर मीटर स्क्वायर किलोमीटर ऑलवेज और यू कैन राइट 1.40 मीटर स्क्वायर ऑल्सो मीटर टू द पावर 2 ऑल्सो यू कैन राइट और स्क्वायर मीटर ऑल्सो यू कैन राइट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 फाइंड द एरियाज ऑफ द स्क्वायर हूज साइड्स आर 5 मीटर. सो लेट अस सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन. Given the side of a square is equal to 5 meter. Now area of a square equal to side into side. So 5 into 5. 5 5 is a 25. Now see here square meter. I already explained you. You can write square meter or meter square. Meter to the power 2. Now question number 3. The length and breadth of 3 rectangles are as given below. 9 meter. So same you can solve in this way. Okay. The length given the length of rectangle is equal to 9 meter, breadth is equal to 6 meter, then area of rectangle is equal to length into breadth 9 into 6. So three questions you will solve and after that you will write which one has the largest area and which one has the smallest. So compare the numbers, area and then write. Okay. Now question number 4. The area of rectangular garden 50 meter long is 300 square meter. Find the width of the garden. See here the area of a rectangular garden 300 square meter and length is 50 meter. We will calculate breadth. Let us start. Given the area of garden is equal to 300 square meter, length equal to 50 meter. Now we will write the formula. Area of garden, because garden is in rectangular shape. So we will apply the formula of rectangle. Okay, area of rectangle. So area of garden is equal to length into breadth. In place of area, we will write area equal to length. Length in place of length 50 and breadth is B. Or unknown value is breadth, width. That we have to calculate. So we will keep this left hand side. So or 50b equal to 300. Between 50 and b there is no sign, that means multiplication. Opposite of multiplication is division. So breadth is equal to 300 upon 50. 0 cancel by 0. 5, 6 are 30. So the width of the garden is 6 meter. You will write answer in the full statement. Now fifth question. What is the cost of tiling a rectangular plot of length 500 meter long and 200 meter wide at the rate of rupees 8 per 100 square meter. That means rectangular plot is there, tiles वहाँ पर हमको लगानी है. Length is given 500 meter, breadth is given 200 meter and the cost for one tile is or in the area, that means rupees 8 per 100 square meter. That means the cost of 100 square meter area is rupees 8 for the tiling. Okay, let us start. So in fifth question, given the length of the plot is equal to 500 meter, breadth is equal to 200 meter. So area of plot, length into breadth, because the plot is in the shape of rectangle. So 500 into 200, that means 5 2s are 10, 4 zeros as it is. So area of plot is equal to 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, like 1 lakh square meter. After that, the cost of tiling in 100 square meter area is equal to rupees 8. It is given in the textbook. Then same statement you will repeat. The cost of tiling in 1 square meter area is equal to, this you will write here, and denominator 100, 1 multiplication sign, with multiplication we can neglect. Then the cost of tiling in 1 lakh square meter area is equal to 8 upon 100 into 1 lakh. These two zeros cancel by those two zero. So cost is rupees 8,000 and full statement form you will write. Now question number 6. A table top measures 2 meter by 1 meter 50 centimeter. Here the unit is 2 meter, so we will change breadth also in meter. So in meter the breadth will be 1.5 meter. What is its area in square meter? So table top is in which shape? Rectangle. So you have to calculate the area of rectangle, that means table top, length into breadth. So you will solve this question yourself. A room is 4 meter long and 3 meter 50 centimeter wide. How many square meters of carpet is needed to cover the floor of them? So carpet we have to spread there. That means what we will calculate? Area. And room is in which shape? Rectangle. So here also what you will calculate? Yes, area. Okay. And here meter centimeter. So the breadth will be 3.50 meter. Now add the question. A floor is 5 meter long and 4 meter wide. A square carpet of size 3 meter is laid on the floor. Find the area of the floor that is not carpeted. That means floor is in which shape? Rectangle. So first we will calculate the area of floor. That means area of rectangle. And then carpet is given in the square form. Only side is given. Then we will find the area of carpet. That means square. Area of square. And then subtract. And we will calculate the area of the floor that is not carpeted. Let us start solution. Now given the length of the floor is equal to 5 meter, breadth is equal to 4 meter. Then area of the floor is equal to length into breadth. So 5 fours are 20 square meter. After that, given the side of a square carpet is equal to 3 meter, then area of carpet is equal to side into side. So side into side, that means 3 into 3, 9 square meter. Now the area of the floor that is not carpeted is equal to area of the floor minus area of the carpet. Area of the floor is 20 and area of the carpet is 9. So 20 minus 9 equal to 11 square meter. In the statement form you will write. So the area of the floor that is not carpeted is 11 square meter. Ninth question. 5 square flower beds each of sides 1 meter are dug on the piece of land 5 meter long and 4 meter wide. What is the area of the remaining part of the land? See here. How many beds? 5. And shape is square. And the side of beds is 1. That means in the square shape. So first we will calculate the area of bed is equal to side into side. That means 1 into 1. So 1 square meter. Then how many? 5. So next line you will write. So the area of 5 flower beds is equal to 5 into 1. So 5 square meter. After that, land is in which shape? Rectangular. So length of the land is equal to 5 meter and breadth is equal to 4 meter. Then area of the land is equal to 5 into 4, that means 20. Now what is the area of the remaining part of the land? So the remaining part of the land is equal to area of the land minus area of the 5 square flower beds. So when you will subtract, you will get your answer. So this question you will do yourself. Question number 10. By splitting the following figures into rectangles, find their areas. The measures are given in centimeters. Okay. That means we will draw the shapes and then we will calculate the area of the given figure. So figure number A, we can split in this way. I have joined this point to this, this to this, and so how many shapes we are getting? 1, 2, 3, 4. It is rectangle. The side of rectangle length is 4 and breadth is 2. And here opposite sides always be equal. So 2, so this one also will be 2 and length is 3. So rectangle is there. Now third, this length. So this 3 and this 2. So total length of rectangle number 3 or figure number 3 is 5 and breadth is this. So this will be 1. How? when you will join this to this, so it will be left. So this will be 1, it will be also 1. And here opposite sides always be equal. So in the figure number 4, opposite sides are equal, so it will be square. 3, 3, 3, 3. So in this way, now we will calculate the area of the given figure. Now from the figure, area of rectangle 1 is equal to length into breadth. Length is 4 into 2. So 8 square centimeter. Area of rectangle 2, length into breadth. Length is 3 and breadth is 2. So 3 2s are 6 square centimeter. Area of rectangle 3, length into breadth. 5 into 1, 5 square centimeter. Last shape is square. So area of square, 4 is equal to side into side, 3 into 3, so 9 square centimeter. Now total area is equal to 8 plus 6 plus 5 plus 9, that is 28 square centimeter. Now in the figure number B, when you will join in this way, you will get, see here is 1, so opposite is 1. Same way, here this is 3, this is 3, and 3 plus 2, 5. So total length 5 we have taken. Same way, what when you will join from this to this, this to this, opposite sides are equal. So 1, 1, and total 5. So 1 plus 3, 4 plus 5. So this is figure number 1, and it is in which shape? Rectangle. So, and this now, when you will join, opposite sides are equal. So this is 3, this whole is 3. Okay, so this will be, this is 2, this is 2. So rectangle number 2. Same way, this 2, this 2. And here the breadth will be 1. So in this way, rectangle number 1, 5 into 1, 5 square centimeter. Rectangle number 2, 2 into 1, 2 square centimeter. Rectangle number 3 also 2 into 1, 2 square centimeter. And then total area. So you will do yourself this. Now question number 11 is, split the following shapes into rectangles and find their areas. The measures are given in centimeters. Okay, see here what I have done. I have joined this to this. So opposite sides will be equal. This will be 2, this will be 2. And length, whole length 12. Till here to here 10 and more 2. So total length is 12. So figure number 1. Area of rectangle will be 12 into 2. Now here opposite sides are equal. This 2, this will be also 2. This is 8, this will be also 8. So figure number 2 is also rectangle. So 8 into 2. Whole length is 10, but here 2. So opposite sides always be equal. So 8. And then 8, you will get total area. Now this, in this figure you are getting squares. So all squares are and same side, 7 centimeter, 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7 7. So opposite sides always be equal. This will be 7, this will be 7, this will be 7. So for this, how many you are getting squares with same side? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, right? So what you will do, you will calculate only area of first square. 7 into 7, 49 square centimeter. So area of one square is equal to 49 centimeter square. Then area of 5 square centimeter will be, you will get the answer, because how many squares you are getting here? 5. And in third, you will join till here to here. So total length is 5. So this length also will be 5. Opposite sides will be equal. This one, so this one. So rectangle you are getting. So this area will be 5 into 1, 5 centimeter square. And whole length is 4. 4 into 1, 4 square centimeter. So area of rectangle 1, area of rectangle 2, and then you will calculate total area. Now question number 12. How many tiles whose length and breadth are 12 cm and 5 cm respectively will be needed to fit in a rectangular region whose length and breadth are respectively? Okay, 100 cm and 144 cm. How many tiles? Tiles length and breadth are given. Then region is given. In the rectangular region we have to fix. Okay, so first we will calculate the area of tiles and then area of this. Same way you will solve this one. Okay, I am solving for you this one. In question number 12, you can see given length of a tile is equal to 12 cm, breadth is equal to 5 cm, then area of tile is equal to length into breadth, 12 times 60 square cm. Then given length of rectangular region equal to 100 cm, breadth is equal to 144 cm, then area of rectangular region is equal to length into breadth, that means 100 into 144, so 14,400 square cm. Now, number of tiles we need, area of rectangular region upon area of a tile. So, area of rectangular region we know 14,400 and area of one tile is 60. Cancel this zero by this. When you will divide 1440 by 6, you will get 240. So, how many tiles, 240 tiles needed in that rectangular region? In the statement form, you will write the answer. Same way, you can solve this one. Area of one tile you know. Area of this rectangular region you will calculate. And then divide, you will get answer. Now, a challenge. On a centimeter squared paper, make as many rectangles as you can such that the area of rectangle is 16 square centimeter. Consider only natural numbers length. You will do, children, you will make one video and you will send on my personal WhatsApp number. Which rectangle has the greatest perimeter? Then you have to calculate the perimeter of that rectangle. Which rectangle has the least perimeter? If you take a rectangle of area 24 square centimeter, what will be your answer? Given any area, is it possible to predict the shape of the rectangle with the greatest perimeter, with the least perimeter? Give example and reason. So 2-3 times you will read these questions and you will solve. Now what have we discussed? Perimeter is the distance covered along the boundary forming a closed figure when you go round the figure once. It is the complete definition of perimeter. Perimeter of rectangle 2 in the bracket length plus breadth. Perimeter of a square 4 into length of its side. Perimeter of an equilateral triangle is equal to 3 into length of a side. Equilateral triangle where all sides of a triangle is equal. Figures on which all sides and angles are equal are called a regular closed figure. The amount of surface enclosed by a closed figure is called its area. It is the definition of area. It may be asked. So definition you have to learn. To calculate the area of a figure using a squared paper, the following conventions are adopted. Ignore portions of the area that are less than half a square. If more than half a square is in a region, count it as one square. If exactly half, count half. Area of rectangle is equal to length into breadth. Area of a square is equal to side into side. So here chapter is finished. Already we have finished in the online class, but tutorial I am sending you. So please revise the chapter.